Everyone has their one dumb thing, their one karmic blunder, their one high heel on a jackass, and this was Bridget's. If she had stopped to think for a minute, she might have guessed that the alcohol-free reception had a purpose other than sanctimonious temperance. But that was not her way, and so Bridget did not discover for weeks that the bride and groom had met at an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting. And though they had avoided alcohol for 2 years together, they certainly knew what it smelled like on someone's breath. Slam-dancing guests slurring "sorry" in their faces left little room for doubt. Bridget was unaware of all of this. She was rather pleased with herself, in fact, and decided to chase the impulse, to spur the moment, and that is what brought her to Dave. He was leaning against the wall, draining his second tequila sunrise, when Bridget bounced up to him. "Is your name Dave?" Bridget ventured, though she was quite certain of his name.
"Yes, it is,"
Dave replied, straightening and effortfully avoiding measuring her hips with his eyes. "Dave Wildhack, right?" Bridget gushed like a groupie. She knew his last name was not Wildhack, though she would have liked it to be.
"Wilson," he corrected her. "Dave Wilson. I'm sorry, you must have me confused with someone else."
"Oh, I'm not confused," Bridget grinned. "I just like the name Wildhack. I made it up." She clinked her glass against his and took a sip.
"Oh, you made it up," Dave smiled, though he was nonplussed. "Wildhack."
He raised his glass to her toast and nervously took a large swallow. "Do you like it?"
"Like what?"
"Wildhack."
"As a name?"
Bridget bit her lip and nodded. "It's a fetching name, don't you think?"
"I suppose."
"Tell you what," Bridget nudged him with her glass and affected a Southern Belle accent. "If a dashing Dave Wildhack were to ask me to dance, why, I don't think I could possibly decline."